God, I gotta go. I gotta quit smoking. Atomic Blonde stars Charlize Theron, James McAvoy, and is directed by David Leitch. Man, does this feel weird. What's up, guys? I think it's been like a week since I recorded my last video. I took some downtime, rest and relaxation a little bit, and now I'm just itching to get back and get behind the camera. I'm so glad I'm back here. As you can see, I changed up my background just a little bit. I guess you could say I simplified it. And I retired the Drumdums chair. I'm back to my original chair that I used for the first half of 2015. I miss this chair. It's been sitting in my garage for 2 years almost, but I'm glad to have it back. It's very comfortable, actually. Really comfortable. Should I just do the whole review like this? No, that would be weird. But Atomic Blonde, it's a new Charlize Theron movie based on a graphic novel called The Coldest City. And in Atomic Blonde, Charlize Theron plays Lorraine. She is an agent and she's brought in for this secret mission to obtain this list or protect the guy who has the list up here, and that is Spyglass. And assisting her in this mission is Percival, played by James McAvoy. Now, I gotta say, this movie has a lot going for it. The plot doesn't really get you into this movie. It's really the visuals. It's a very graphic, novel, artsy type of film, visually. At moments, it reminds me of Sin City just a bit. But one thing I love about this movie is that it is actually set in the late 80s, during the whole Berlin Wall conflict. When Ronald Reagan said, tear down this wall, Gorbachev. And so most of this movie takes place before that, and then the last act of the movie, the wall is being torn down. But I can't praise the soundtrack to this movie enough. All the music is that 80s new wave. We're talking George Michael, Flock of Seagulls, New Order, and of course 99 Luft Balloons by Nina. And really, they use a lot of that music in this movie, strategically. And you could talk about a movie like Suicide Squad that leans way too heavily on music. And the reason that doesn't work so much is because the music doesn't really fit that particular movie. It's not really a link in that chain. Whereas in this movie, the music feels like it serves a purpose throughout, even if it leans on the music just a little bit too much. But if anything, it kept me interested all the way through. If there was a scene where I maybe started getting a little bored, losing interest, there would be a song that would pop up that would pull me right back in. That and the visuals. Visually speaking, Charlize Theron, fantastic in this role, actually. And it's not a role where she has to completely go batshit bonkers acting-wise like she does in, say, Monster. No, like I said, this is more of a visual type of film. But where she really shines is in the action department. Some might say that this is this year's female version of John Wick. I would say no, not really, even though there are a couple of really awesome action scenes. Charlize does most of her stunts in the action scenes of this film. But the last fight scene in this movie, you'll see a little bit of that in the trailer, and thank God they didn't show you too much of it, because if you watch the scene, you'd swear that there are no cuts in it. Even though there probably are, but it's edited in a way where it seems like there are no cuts. And I swear the scene goes on for like 15 minutes. And by the end of the scene, Charlize Theron must have been completely tired. But it is a spectacle to look at. I can't stress that enough. So is Charlize Theron. Now, as far as any cons, I kind of touched on this earlier. I think it does lean a bit too much in the style over substance department. But I think when you're dealing with material that's based on a graphic novel, you get a little bit of leeway there. Also, the character Lorraine, played by Charlize Theron, I would have liked to know a little bit more about her backstory, because there's very little touched on in this movie. And she is an interesting character. Also, James McAvoy, he is decent in this, but at the end of the day, I didn't really care too much about him. And there is a twist at the end, but I don't think it's anything great, if not predictable. But overall, guys, in the end, I definitely give this a high humdrum. I had a good time with it, especially in the second half. It really grabbed hold of me in the second half, and it didn't let go. So anyway, guys, what are your thoughts on Atomic Blonde? Looking forward to hearing them. Also, be sure to come over to Killed Flicks, where we talk horror all day, every day. And on Fridays, we do Free For All Fridays. Follow me at Drumdums on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd. If you like what I'm doing, hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and Drumdum out.